Throughout this series, you've seen me use this website to debug our web APIs we work on it. And you're probably wondering, well, what is this site? Where did it come from? And how does it know so much information about our web API? Well, that's what we're going to talk about in this video. We're going to learn how we're able to debug our web API using something called the Swagger UI. Now, Swagger is a collection of open source tools that make it easier for developers to build and consume web APIs. Some of those tools include things like client generation, API documentation, and even the ability for us to debug our APIs live using this UI. Underneath all of those tools, Swagger relies on something known as the Open API specification. And that spec allows us to define some of the detailed things that our APIs are able to do. Now, we're going to dive deeper into the Open API specification a little bit later in the series. But for now, let's head over to Visual Studio and see how Swagger is enabled in some of our ASP.NET Core Web API templates. Swagger support in ASP.NET Core can be enabled by installing a NuGet package called Swashbuckle. If you're using the Web API templates in .NET 5, then this package will be available to you by default whenever you create a new project. Let's take a look at our startup.cs file and see how some of these things get set up. On line 26, I'm going to look at my configure services method. And inside here, you should see a call to add Swagger Gen. And inside of that, we're specifying the name of our API as well as the version. As we move down a little bit to the configure method, in the first few lines, we can see that we're enabling Swagger support, but only if our application is running in development mode. So that means that if you publish this app to production, then we shouldn't see some of these additional Swagger features. On line 41, we make a call to use Swagger. And this enables the generation of that open API document that we could use to get some really detailed information about our API endpoints. Then on line 42, there's a call to use Swagger Gen. And we point that to that API endpoint. On line 42, we make a call to use Swagger UI. And that enables that web page UI experience that we've been using so far to test out our APIs. All we have to do is point it to that open API document that we generated in that previous line. Let's go ahead and run this. Now that our page is up, you should have a good idea about where some of this information comes from. On the top left, we can see the name of our API as well as the version. And then on the right side, on the select definition, we can see the different documents that are available for us to try out. And so far, there's only one. In the middle of this document, we can see the different operations that are available on our API. And like you've seen before, we can inspect this and see the different parameters our API expects. We can try it out and run it live and see what it actually feels like. And also, we can see the different responses that are returned from our API. This is a really good experience, not just for building web APIs locally by yourself, but also sharing with your team so they can learn about some of the capabilities of your API endpoints. In a future video, we'll dive a little bit further into Open API, and we'll learn about some of the other features that we could use to really customize this UI.